meantime, we've got this Fox News alert for you. The White House today is keeping a very close eye on new protests in Iran. The uprising in Egypt fueling anti-government sentiment in Tehran. And the hardline regime is now threatening to kill opposition protesters who have come out in full force over the past 24 hours. How does the administration plan to handle this situation? And have they had a hand in causing it? Monica Crowley is a radio talk show host and Fox News contributor. Monica, over the past several days, we have heard from Hillary Clinton, we have heard from President Obama, we have heard from the National Security Advisor, we have heard from the White House Press Secretary, outgoing Robert Gibbs, that seem to be stoking the fires now of opposition leaders or protesters in Iran, whereas they didn't do so a year ago. But now they seem to have gotten the message. Now they're stoking the fires, but critics are coming out and saying it's too late, and now we're going to have blood on our hands if we continue that.
It's so interesting, Megyn, because almost immediately after President Obama took office, he went to Cairo for this great speech to the Muslim world. It wasn't just meant for the Arab world. It was meant for the greater Muslim world. Folks in Iran heard that message. It was about greater economic and political liberalization, trying to encourage these regimes to sort of crack themselves open and allow greater voices for their people, which ironically was a very strong message of his predecessor, George W. Bush. So President Obama gave that message, delivered it to the Muslim world, and yet when push came to shove, whether it was in Iran nearly 2 years ago or in the initial stages of the Egypt uprising, you know, revolutions are hard. So when the American president says, hey, we'll stand with you if you go ahead and do this, well, then when it actually starts to happen, the American president does need to stand for something. And what we saw 2 years ago in Iran when the first wave of this started was a very, very tepid statement from the White House.
We didn't.
Where they basically said, the president said, I don't want to meddle in Iran's internal affairs.
And in President Obama's defense, his Cairo message included that piece, too. He said, you know, great democracy, yes, freedom, but it's, you know, up to you to determine what's going to happen within your country, and we're not going to meddle. And that seemed to be sort of a message, I'm no George Bush. I'm not going to continue the old policies. Yeah. But so you're right. So when the uprising took place in Iran, we didn't meddle. And President Obama was criticized for that, for not being a stronger voice in support of the protesters, the opposition protesters. Very different message now in the wake of Egypt. I mean, specifically reaching out to the people. We have a soundbite from President Obama just yesterday. This is just one example. Listen.
My hope and expectation is that we're going to continue to see the people of Iran have the courage to be able to express their yearning for greater freedoms and a more representative government. Understanding that America cannot ultimately dictate what happens inside of Iran any more than it could inside of Egypt.
So it seems to be a similar message, though he's trying to sort of stoke the fires, but saying, hey, but we're not gonna meddle.
Yeah, you know what, Megyn, that statement yesterday, really, I was listening to it and I thought, could he spare it? That was such a sort of non-energetic, tepid kind of statement where when the Egyptian people were uprising, he gave a series of relatively strong statements here. And I think when you're dealing In relative cases, the case of Iran, in terms of moral clarity, is a much clearer case. You have a regime that's an enemy of the United States and has been for over 30 years.
Yes, but Hillary Clinton came out yesterday. She was more forceful. Hillary was more forceful than Barack Obama was. And just yesterday on Fox, Michael Schuller, the former CIA guy, he came on and called her, said she sounded bloodthirsty, said she's safe here and encouraging kids to go out and get shot on the streets of Iran. I mean, our top diplomats need to be very careful about how they stoke the fires, if at all.
I will say, to Hillary Clinton's credit, she did give a stronger statement, but that's the kind of thing I want to hear from the American president. Again, Megyn, the Iranian situation in terms of moral clarity is so much clearer for the United States than Egypt was when you were dealing with a long-standing stalwart ally. The regime in Tehran is the greatest threat to world peace. They're seeking nuclear weapons 24 hours a day. They export terror. They have terrorist proxies in Hamas and Hezbollah. They support al-Qaeda. I mean, to me, this is a no-brainer that the American president should stand up in very forceful terms and say, we stand with the people of Iran. And the United States behind the scenes should be doing a lot more
that's the question.
Overtly.
Then what happens if they go out there? What do we do if they go out there en masse?
The ultimate objective is regime change in Tehran that will solve the nuclear problem and the terrorism problem as well coming out of there.
Monica Crowley, thank you.